So one of the main themes from the Lord of the Rings movies is a really good example of a piece of music that really plays with the major and minor relationship. Technically, it's in a minor key, but it sounds very heroic and dramatic to us. You'll hear in the melody, it emphasizes C down to B flat. I actually don't know what key it is. I'm just assuming we're talking in C for the moment for this presentation. But the top note, the tonic C, ba, 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 you'll hear that. And then below that, you'll hear actually the minor one chord going up to the flat three, which you would think, ba, da, da, tends to be a sort of dark or dramatic interval. But here it sounds kind of heroic because of the way that it's scored, because of the tempo, because of the way that the melody goes. So you'll hear the bass moving in counterpoint with the melody. The U2 song With or Without You is a really good example of the kind of looping chord progression that we find a lot in popular music. So we see the one chord, the tonic, the stable center of the key, that goes to the dominant first, and then we see a couple of alternate chords that we kind of move around to. So let's listen to that example. Progression 1 5 6 4.
See the stone set in your eyes, see the thorn twist in your side.
So you got the idea. Finally, I want to talk about a really interesting example from the movie Inception from a few years ago. Now, what we've heard and the large majority of popular music and classical music kind of, has this pairing of melody with harmonies, and usually both the melody and the harmony are very clearly related to a key. But it's also a special effect that a lot of composers like to take advantage of to use chords that are not related in a single key, and it kind of gives you this disorienting dramatic sense. So if you look at this set of four chords, you realize number one, I haven't even tried to use Roman numerals here, because you actually can't fit all four chords into a single key. It's very rare to see both G natural here, G minor, and G flat in the same key. You wouldn't see two different variations of the same note name. So we have G minor, G flat major. E flat major could be in a G minor chord, or it could be, or sorry, it could be in a G minor key, or it could be in the key of G flat major, but not both at once. And then finally, B major definitely does not go in the key of E flat major. It definitely does not go in the key of G minor, or even the key of G flat major. It would go in G major. So you have this set of four chords that are tonally very, very distant to each other. They're not related in any single key. You really can't find one key that brings them all together. But a lot of the individual notes are very close. G down to G flat, back up to G, for example. So Hans Zimmer takes advantage of a lot of these whole and half step relationships to string chords together, but they don't actually imply a single key, and that's really important to this piece. It really gives this dramatic, disorienting sense. This particular version of it is from the beginning of the movie, when they're in the castle and the water comes streaming in because the dream is coming apart, and the Mal shows up and kind of messes everything up. But this motif recurs throughout the movie, and it kind of comes to represent how reality is distorted. And in terms of the harmony, Hans Zimmer is distorting the harmony that we would actually expect to hear. And it's a really interesting, evocative piece of music. So this is an example of how chords can be used outside of the setting of a major or minor scale to really convey dramatic effect. So this loop is G minor, G flat major, E flat major, B major, and then back to G minor.